Thank you for the warm welcome, man. We appreciate y'all. Thank you so much. The more fucking noise you make, the crazier we get. Let's go. How many people here tonight have seen Extreme for the first time? Where the fuck have you been? That's all crowd and shit, man. Yeah, we've ignored you for 40 years. How do you feel about that? I'm completely fucking with you, man. That mix is so goddamn exciting with new album out and all. Thank you so much for all the new fans and anybody who hasn't seen the truth the first time tonight. God Damn, that was the most I think ever did you proud, man. How many of you have seen us way back in the 1900s when we first started this show? I believe you. You too young. Wasn't even born yet. Come on. Everybody was there in the beginning, man. We played for five people and then we played. We so appreciate y'all coming down tonight. Listen, Pornograffiti was not our first album, for those of you who don't know. We had an album before that simply just called Extreme. We just did that. I don't know why we didn't name it, but every fucking band we grew up with just had one after Extreme 1. And let's also say, it's gotta be cool to fucking just self-title your album. But anyways, for you who don't know, we're gonna do a little medley for you right now. Take you back down memory lane, if that's cool. I promise you'll dig it. I think so. Okay, so let's do this. Let's blow the roof off this fucking place. Let's go. Thank you. much, man. I appreciate y'all. Thank you. You guys feeling all right so far?
Yeah!
Oh, you sound fucking all right so far. Let me tell you. I know I'm old as fuck, but I still remember my name. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you. My mother thanks you. But listen, man. Something I want to say to you, man. We know that all this fucking energy in the room, and we know that it basically takes Extreme roughly around 31 to 33 years to do an album. Yeah, we gotta get our shit together for sure. But we're working on that. We're, you know, dysfunctional families. Come on, everybody can relate to that shit. But it's not for a lack of effort. We had a lot of music, but you know, we said to each other a long, long time ago that we were like 17. He said, man, we never want to release anything just for the sake of fucking releasing something to decide. And has to, you know. Selfishly, we have to be so fucking excited about it, and it has to mean something to us before it can ever mean something to you. So we wanted to make sure that always when we release anything, that it's got to be something that has something to say, something we're super proud of. But having said that, you know, man, a bunch of fucking 50-somethings, 60-somethings. Oh, I'm sorry. We have a child in the band. He's 47 or some shit. Give it up for K-Fig, the youngster of the group. Basically, what I'm trying to say is, man, and the point of our career and our lives at our age, man, we had no business getting the love and the response that we've gotten on this album from all of you, and we owe you. Great, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you so much, man. I appreciate it. Can't do a fucking show without y'all, man. It's not worth having a fucking album if you're not gonna listen to it. That meant the world to us. Thank you so much. We are so grateful. We don't take you for granted. Thank you so much. Sorry, I forgot. More importantly, I got a bit of a wardrobe change. I definitely paid too much for this fucking hat in Nashville. Fucking went down to Nashville one of the first times. I was like, man, you know, I want to fucking get some local shit. You know? I feel like party went down there to write and doing. I gotta fucking be cool when I go down there. I went to this local hat shop. And they were just like, I walked in. I said, man. Been waiting like 30, 35 years to find the right fucking hat. What do you got? And he said to me, in the back, there was a hat that's been waiting for you for 35 years. And I'm like, no shit. Yeah, he is. So he brought it out. It's like some fucking crazy handmade Turkish fabric. I don't know what it is. I don't know what's happening. But feather of some extinct dinosaur or something. It's because he said, for you, this is $7,000.
Oh, shit.
I'm no fucking dumb. I'm not that stupid, man. So I bought that fucker right on the spot. No way I'm giving up that opportunity. It happened waiting for me for that long. Man. But you know, next night I'm like, okay, it's time to go down and fucking, you know, be cool, go down to Nashville, all the clubs, the bars, watch everybody play. And I'm walking around, I'm like, oh, fucking, my hat is good. And I was a hat just like mine. There's another one.
Oh, shit.
Anyways, God bless America. That's what it's all about.
Yeah!
God
bless America.
Should have bought this shit in Texas. That's the problem. But you know what? It's not very cool to say it these days, but God bless this country of ours, of America, right?
Yeah! Yes, sir.
Can we do a new song off the six after that fucking moment? We need your voices, though, for this. Honestly, man. We're on tour a bit, we got, you know, we can still sing, but it's more like a fucking sexy 1-800 kind of voices. So we need your voices, here we go.
Yeah.
song as well, right? We want you to sing loud and proud. Man, that gives me an idea. I think maybe right after the show, we all of us, myself included, meet outside after the show. We exchange, you know, social, email, cells, whatever. We start a fucking band together. Of course, I'll be the manager. The manager gets to stay home and he makes all the money. Trust me, I know. But you know, it's okay. The only issue is probably, you know, after your first single, our first single, should I say, You're not going to make a lot of money because there's too many of you. I'm going to split the royalties. So you'll probably break up right away. It's okay. We'll come back. Come back to this venue. We'll do like a farewell show. Long show.
And, who's with me?
Are you with me? Woo! I'm in. I'm all in. I'll share 20% of my 100 with you all. Is that okay? That's how it works in the music business. Anyways, K Fig, my favorite fucking rock and roll drummer. Give me a groove.
Thank you. Thank you.
lot. Thank you so much. You guys still here? You okay?
Good. This is my absolute favorite part of the show right here.
We got some cable TV coming on if anybody wants to watch us fucking Netflix. Security's like, fucking ESPN.
I don't like Netflix.
Serious.
Netflix?
This is certainly, they take care of our bands there. Like, if we get bored with our show, watch a little fucking, you know, like, fucking Ozark or some shit.
Ozark.
Anyway. I can't unsee this. You're doing the wrong HDMI, by the way.
It's distracting.
Keep scrolling. It's the second one. Apple TV, right? Anyways, man.
It's distracting.
This is my absolute favorite part of the show, as I was saying, because I finally get to sit the fuck
down.
When you turn like 57, sitting down is like having an orgasm. You know what I'm talking. Sorry, parents. Sorry. It is a rock show. Until we're now in our fucking living room. I don't know. All right. Before I play these next billion notes, I want you all to put your hands and hearts together for the one and only Living Color Red. What a great fucking band, underrated band in my opinion. Great musicians, great writers, fucking, but most of all, man, some of the most incredible people you will ever meet on this planet. Give it up one more time for Living Color. I'm so excited to do this with them. We've been talking about doing this for decades, and wow. We both had a little bit outside the box back in the day, you know, amongst rock and metal, and having a little bit of a funk element where people were confused about us, but you know what, I was super excited until I was like, oh fuck, Vernon's going on before me. Is that cool? And I'm like, fuck man, so I figured I'll call him up and be like, hey man, I'm excited you're coming on, you know, maybe if you just pull it back a little bit. Kind of before I go on, you know, maybe all this kind of fusion, jazz, crazy shit that I don't understand in the key of be quiet or whatever the fuck is. Nah, man, I'm just fucking with you. Give it up for Vernon. Come on.
How many guitar players in the house tonight?
Wow. Fucking, that's why you're all staring, judging me through every fucking, through every solo. I see it. I feel it. It burns, man, but it's great. Now, man, honestly, I'm so happy this guitar player's here tonight because the truth of the matter is that, you know, having done what, you know, I've done with Extreme as a guitar player and selling records and all the success we've had is amazing, no doubt. But I'm telling you right now, the success of this shit, for real, the happiness is playing this instrument, period.
Yeah!
It don't matter if you're playing in your fucking basement, your garage, you're playing in a cover band, you're doing whatever it is online. The fucking truth is you're doing it because you love it, and that's really the secret to this whole fucking thing. When you put this shit on, it's like a superpower, man. Nobody can fuck with you, no one. So you know what? All your wives, let them buy that 23rd guitar they've been eyeing out there. After they take you to dinner, of course. McDonald's, because they need the money for that fucking guitar. Woo! Anyways, here's to all the guitar, please keep a guitar alive in this room tonight. Come on.
Thank you.
Thanks for that silence, man. I don't know what chord that is. I love it. It's like a perverted ninth or some shit. I don't know what it's called. For anybody out there, this little tiny number is for you if you have gone through something I've gone through recently, and if you lose or have lost somebody in your life, somebody near and dear to you, somebody in your family, your best friend or whatnot, man, it's tough when that happens to any of us. And for me, it's like, you know, you put pen to paper, try to get a melody out and get that shit out and try to heal through writing a song. And I hope this song off the album called Hurricane has helped heal anybody out there tonight. I hope that. Spun my heart back in the time. Brand new day, nothing to hide. God, it feels like yesterday. Yeah.
Yeah, but we've been drinking wine. Stop it, sing, stop it, time. Just melt away.
Your hands and touch me.
that you love me.
This is all you, come on. Anyways, man, enough of that sentimental shit.
Ah, I have to
beat him with that.
Too emotional. Shit, they turned off my favorite show. Listen, we're gonna keep you ready to go back some rock and roll. Is that okay? Before we move along, though, we wanted to do just a little thank you song. Give it up for John, my tech slash. He says, bitch. Hey, I didn't say it. I'm an asshole. Anyways, I want to do a little something for all these. There's a species in the house that I don't think these days get enough love, enough respect. And that's all the women in this room tonight. Incredible mothers out there, the jobs that you do, incredible our daughters, sisters, all of you out there, man, this is for you, a little something.
Oh, you gonna
to break up again?
Houston, we got a problem.
Oh, shit.
That's what happens when you hit too hard like that motherfucker right there.
I've been waiting all night to say that.
I was hoping you weren't ever going to say that. Holy shit, man. I was in my own hoedown space.
Shit happens.
That's you got to give it up for King Fit for hitting too hard and breaking the fuck out of here. Alright, I'm gonna pretend that didn't happen, right?
That's alright.
up for Gary Cherone on them there vocals. Breaks them.
Thank you. She won't keep them waiting. Dreams
that cool? Can we take a family photo with y'all? Is that
all
right? As soon as the breaker of all drums gets down here, get your fucking hands up. Let's make this sword.
This was a 2-hour and 5-minute set. Oh, recording now. Oh my god. That was an awesome, awesome performance. Oh my god. That may have been the best performance I've ever seen live, and I've seen a lot of concerts, but god damn, this was the best performance all around. And I've seen Muse, I've seen Guns N' Roses, I've seen Foo Fighters, I've seen Pearl Jam, I've seen a shitload of bands, but god damn, this is a badass concert. Woo! 2-hour and 5-minute set. House of Blues, Houston, Texas. I forgot how awesome it is. The sound, the acoustics, the lights. It's been a while since I've been here. I came here back in September. And I missed it, and honestly did miss it. I'm so glad I was able to make it out here. I'm very happy, very, very happy, content, fulfilled. It was worth the wait. I'm hoping that you guys enjoyed the set. This is the walk out of the House of Blues towards our cars. And oh my god, what an amazing set. I'd be lying to you if I told you that I didn't cry during more than words. Dono is one hell of a guitar player. I'm actually I had never seen someone play the guitar like that, and I've seen a lot of guitar solos, but good god have mercy, that dude is something else. My respects to the entire band, their organization. I really do wish them the best as they continue about their tour throughout the U.S. Living Color, second time I've seen them. First time I saw them was over at a Warehouse Live Midtown, what is now Midtown. But wow, I can't believe I just saw that set. I mean, I was surprised when I saw a 3-hour set from Guns N' Roses, but 2 hours and 5 sets from this band was freaking. It's taking a while for it to. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed the set. It was an amazing set. And you know where to follow Rockfest Houston on YouTube, Rockfest Houston Radio on Instagram, Rockfest Houston Radio, and TikTok, Rockfest Houston Radio and Facebook, Rockfest Houston on YouTube, where you can find tonight's sets on there and many other ones that I've been able to cast throughout the years. 1080p, I was recorded with the best. I tried doing the best job I can as far as recording with the best view, best close-ups with my amazing iPhone 14, 14 Pro Max. Simply does amazing recordings, and I'm just amazed how this concert was tonight. It was an amazing experience, and as is usual, Live Nation putting together amazing events. I got another one coming up on the 29th. This will be Enanos Verdes. After seeing him perform a few years ago, right before Marcelo Cantero died. So it'll be special on the 29th here, House of Blues. And I'm looking forward to that one too. I want to see how the sound sounds with Felipe Staipe singing and vocals. And then, of course, we have other, looks like I'll be in, hopefully in Austin, Texas, Del Valle, Texas for the, for the Besame Mucho Music Festival there. And then hopefully in March, I'll be in, at the end in Monterrey for Pan Norte. So I'm trying to get as many events as possible. You simply do not know when the band's performances might be, the last bands might be. So I am very happy that I'm able to attend these events, and I'm hoping you guys enjoy the performances. You know where to follow us. Take care. This was Extreme with Living Color opening up for them here at House of Blueshouston, Texas. Catch my breath here. Take care. Bye.